Welcome to the part 3 of Introductory Mathematics for AI. So far, we have finished part 1 and 2. Now, we will start part 3, AI and Optimal Solution, which is a part of calculus. Each week, we will have three short lectures. One will be the preview on the web. So we will preview what we're going to learn in this week. And second, in the main lecture, we will follow our textbook to cover the main contents of our lectures. And then we will have a review and practice on the web page and with the code in it. Okay. So far, we have had the lecture on syllabus and lecture on preview. And lecture 2 was given for the graph of functions. Lecture 3 was on the finding solutions of equations. And then we learned operations of vectors, and then we defined the matrix and tensor, and we learned the matrix operations. Then we defined the inner product and the norm of vectors to define the data similarities on distance and the angle. The cosine similarity was covered in lecture 6. Then, in lecture 7, we have learned how to find the solution set of a given linear system of equations by finding the solution set for the corresponding homogeneous linear system of equation and the particular solution for AX is equal to B. With those informations, we were able to find the whole set of solutions for the given linear system of equation AX is equal to B. Then we learned how to find the least square solution, the best possible solution for the linear system of equations. And then we learned the singular value decomposition as well as LU and QR matrix factorizations. Singular value decomposition is one of the most important part of mathematics for introductory mathematics for AI. Then we started the calculus by defining the limit and continuity and the derivatives. And then, now we're gonna start the AI and optimal solution. And it starts with the local maximum and minimum. In here, we will learn the application of derivatives and application of second derivative, and local maximum and minimum, and absolute maximum and minimum. Okay, we will define the increasing function and decreasing function with the derivative, and we will use the tangent line, the slope of a tangent line, to define the increasing and decreasing at a certain point. So the examples will be find all increasing and decreasing intervals for a given function, then applications of a second derivative here. We will have functions, then the critical point will be found, and then we will find the inflection point by the second derivatives, which gives us the local maximum and minimum. Those second derivatives will give us a very important information for finding local maximum and minimum. Like here, local minimum and local maximum. Those will be decided by the second derivative. That's what you're gonna learn in this week. So from the given function, we will find the intervals where this function is concave up or concave down. And those information will give us a local minimum and local maximum, and local maximum, local minimum, and then in the whole interval, we will find the absolute maximum and absolute minimum value of the function on the interval. Fermat's theorem, Fermat's theorem for extrema, or known as an interior extremum theorem, will be introduced. It says if f of x has an extreme value at x is equal to c, then f prime of c is equal to 0 or f prime of c does not exist. So if we want to find the extreme value of a given function, all we have to do first is to try to find the solution for the f prime of x is equal to 0 to find those c first. That's what we're gonna learn. Here we will have a local maximum at this point, and we will have a local minimum at this point, which can be found at the critical point where f prime of x is equal to 0, and the second derivative at that point will give us those concave upward and concave downward information. So problems are like this. When we want to find the maximum or minimum, the first step is find all critical points of f on the interval and find the function values at all critical points and the function values at the end point. Compare all those values, then we will be able to find the local maximum and minimum, and absolute maximum and absolute minimum of the function on the interval. Okay, Fermat's extrema theorem was introduced. I think that's what we're going to learn in this week. Expect what we will learn this week.